Welcome once again, everyone, in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who is the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. And it is Tuesday, May 26th. Yesterday was the 25th. So today is the 26th of May. And so today's topic for the devotional will be titled Dreams at Sunset. So we'll get to that in a minute. But first, we're going to do the daily scripture song for today. The 26th, so let me turn there, it's on the wrong page. So we're going to be pressing play on the CD that Brother Dean and Sister Patty have put together for this month years ago, and they've made all for every single month, for every single day of the year, so you can sing a scripture song and learn them all, and it's a good way to learn scripture, amen, by putting them to song. And so that's what him and Sister Patty did years ago, and put them on CDs, and you can also go download them, I believe, on the website, which is www.dailyscripturesongs.com. So we're going to be doing Micah 6, verse 8 today. So if you have a Bible or a Bible app on your phone, you can turn there and sing along to this scripture as he put it to song. So I will press play here. I will stop rambling on, and we'll get to it. So Micah 6, 8. And let me read it really fast for you here. It says, He hath showed thee, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy God. So let's push play here, and he'll say it again, and then we'll sing it. Amen.
Micah 6:8. Yep. He hath showed thee, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy God.
Okay, here we go. He hath showed thee, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy God. He has shown thee, O man, what is good, and what does the Lord require of thee, but to do justly, and to love mercy, walk humbly with thy God. Walk humbly with thy God. Amen. All right, let's try that one more time.
Micah 6:8. He hath showed thee, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy God.
He hath showed thee, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy God. He has showed thee, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy God. To walk humbly with thy God. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let me put that back to the beginning there, and we'll try that a couple more times at the end of the broadcast. But now let me grab the devotional book, and we will start in on this topic of dreams at sunset. And it says here in 2 Chronicles 18:34b, And about the time of the sun going down, he died. So, hopefully we'll find out. Let's go ahead and open up 2 Chronicles and find out who this person was that died really quick, because it's good to have some context with the, especially with old, with scripture here. Context is good, because we don't want to take anything out of context. So let's find out who it is here that they're talking about. 2 Chronicles 18:34. So 18:34. All right, so let's see. Who is it that we're talking about here? Go back here. So it looks like they're talking about, in the this particular chapter, it's talking about King, the King of Israel said to Jehoshaphat, "I will disguise myself." So who's the king here at this time? The King of Israel. So they give the King of Israel here. All right. Well, anyway, it says here that the King of Israel, not sure who the king was at that time. Might have been David or Solomon or Jehoshaphat, one of those people. But anyway, says here, and the king of Israel said unto Jehoshaphat, "I will disguise myself." So Jehoshaphat wasn't a king, but the king of Israel was saying to Jehoshaphat, "I will disguise myself and will go to the battle, but put thou on thy robes," he says. So the king of Israel disguised himself, and they went to the battle. Now the king of Syria had commanded the captain of the chariots that were with him, saying, "Fight ye not with small or great, save only with the king of Israel." And it came to pass, when the captains of the chariots saw Jehoshaphat, that they said, "It is the king of Israel." Therefore they compassed about him to fight. But Jehoshaphat cried out, and the Lord helped him, and God moved them to depart from him. For it came to pass that when the captains of the chariots perceived that it was not the king of Israel, they turned back again from pursuing him. And verse 33 says, "And a certain man drew a bow at a venture and smote the king of Israel between the joints of the harness. Therefore he said to his chariot man, 'Turn thine hand, that thou mayest carry me out of the host, for I am wounded.'" And then verse 34 says, "And the battle increased that day. Howbeit, the king of Israel stayed himself up in his chariot against the Syrians until the even, and about the time of the sun going down, he died." So we're talking about the king of Israel there. So it's always good to get context, even though I'm sure that he's might be going somewhere else with this, but we want context. We want to know what's going on there, because you can't take something out of context if there's a context with it, because then it can mess everything up, even though we might be trying to get something else out of it. Amen. So good to know that. All right, so that was the king of Israel there that died. So again, it says, "And about the time of the sun going down, he died." 2 Chronicles 18:34b. And our author today is Brother Tim Green from Revival in Our Times, Day Heights, Ohio. And so let's see what he has to say here about this topic of the sun, or dreams at sunset. And he says here, as I read and you listen, and he wrote, he says, "The closing hours of Israel's perhaps most worthless, if not worst king, are distinguished by this ignominious end." And I will leave it at that, he says. So he says, "I will leave it at that." And then he writes, "I have observed with great delight the sun setting on the beautiful Lake Michigan, and quite often watched that same flaming orb drop silently into the Gulf of Mexico." And yes, sunsets are beautiful thing to see. Praise the Lord for those sunsets. Sometimes in a deer stand or while driving along, He says, I have been blessed to see the amazing sight of a glorious sunset. Amen. Me too. Like I said, praise the Lord for those sunsets. So he continues on, the sunset of life sometimes catches one unaware of its presence as it sneaks up on the unsuspecting way too early in life. So he says again, the sunset of life sometimes catches one unaware of its presence as it sneaks up on the unsuspecting way too early in life. However, as one ages, the time of life's departure is an obvious fact, even though the hour of its appearance remains elusive but unavoidable. Yes, so death is unavoidable. We're all going to die one day. So if you die without Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, well, you're going to end up in hellfire, and you're going to be under God's judgment for the rest of your days. Certainly don't want to go there, friend. God doesn't want you to perish. He wants you to come to repentance and put your faith and trust in Him and Him alone. Amen. So, let's continue on here. He says, Paul was aware and said, the time of my departure is at hand. So, this is Paul speaking. And that was in 2 Timothy 4, verse 6. And now let's continue on as we read here. Or I read and you listen. Amen. An old book by the same title as today's devotional sent my thoughts traveling the same road that all life's beings have or will travel. And he says, our dreams for others at the sunset of our days. If one is married, the dream would contain the blessed hope that this nightmarish experience would be tempered and accomplished by God's all-sufficient grace. Okay. I guess he's talking about death. I hope he's not talking about marriage. Marriage should be a good thing, as long as you have the Lord in the midst of it. So perhaps he's continued talking about death here. Hope that's the case. Again, the dream would include a bright hope for children and loved ones to soon meet again in the never-ending day of heaven's revelry. The vision of reflection for the future of things once loved and enjoyed would be reverend and enlarged by the length of one's shadow in the waning hours of life's day. All our dreams at the sunset of life are filtered through our faith in the Heavenly Father and seen through the prism of, I shall be satisfied when I awake with thy, and he puts in here in this caption here, his likeness, with thy his likeness. Psalm 17:15, and we know that's talking about Jesus, God Almighty. And he concludes here, he says, I would like to say, glory to God and hallelujah. Amen. So let's say glory to God and hallelujah. And one day we'll be with Jesus Christ in heavenly places, if you're saved, that is. So while we're down here, let's keep doing what he would have us to do and keep following him and obeying him to best our ability and not give in to the flesh and the devil and the world. Amen. The lust of the eyes, the lust of in the ways of the world. So, forgot to have that. I know I wasn't going to quote that verse right, but praise the Lord that everyone's going to die one day. But if you die and go be with Jesus, that will be a much better place than on this earth. But while we're on this earth, let's learn to love one another. And if you're married, learn to love your spouse and serve the Lord together. And whatever issues you might be having in your marriage or your friendships or whatever it may be, take it to the Lord and He will help you with it and get you through it. Amen. So praise the Lord for that. All right. So that is the end of our topic on dreams at sunset. And so that will conclude that. And so tomorrow's topic will be titled Faith to Reach Others. So I hope you'll come back tomorrow for that. Let's put that aside for right now, and we will get into the Proverbs reading for today as we turn to Proverbs chapter 26. So if you have your King James Bible handy, please turn along with me and we will read this chapter. All right, Proverbs 26 and verse 1 says, "As snow in summer and as rain in harvest, so honor is not seemly for a fool. As the bird by wandering, as the swallow by flying, so the curse causeless shall not come." Excuse me, shall not come. "A whip for the horse, a bridle for the ass, and a rod for the fool's back. Answer not a fool according to his folly, lest thou also be like unto him. Answer a fool according to his folly, lest he be wise in his own conceit." So there's sometimes you need to answer a fool, and then there's other times where you don't need to answer him. That's basically what it's saying. 6. "He that sendeth a message by the hand of a fool cutteth off the feet and drinketh damage." That's always been a rough one there. Wow, drinketh damage. "The legs of the lame are not equal, so is a parable in the mouth of fools. As he that bindeth a stone in a sling, so is he that giveth honor to a fool. As a thorn goeth up into the hand of a drunkard, so is a parable in the mouth of fools. The great God that formed all things both rewardeth the fool and rewardeth transgressors. As a dog returneth to his vomit, so a fool returneth to his folly. Seest thou a man wise in his own conceit? There is more hope of a fool than of him." "The slothful man saith, there is a lion in the way. A lion is in the streets. As the door turneth upon his hinges, so doth the slothful upon his bed. The slothful hideth his hand in his bosom. It grieveth him to bring it again to his mouth. The sluggard is wiser in his own conceit than seven men that can render a reason. He that passeth by and meddleth with strife belonging not to him is like one that taketh a dog by the ears." Yeah, I don't want to do that. "As a madman who casteth firebrands, arrows, and death, so is the man that deceiveth his neighbor and saith, am not I in sport? Where no wood is, there the fire goeth out. So where there is no talebearer, the strife ceaseth. As coals are to burning coals and wood to fire, so is a contentious man to kindle strife. The words of a talebearer are as wounds, and they go down into the innermost parts of the belly. Burning lips and a wicked heart are like a potsherd covered with silver dross. He that hateth dissembleth with his lips, and layeth up deceit within him. When he speaketh fair, believe him not, for there are seven abominations in his heart, whose hatred is covered by deceit. His wickedness shall be showed before the whole congregation. Whoso diggeth a pit shall fall therein, and he that rolleth a stone, it will return upon him. A lying tongue hateth those that are afflicted by it, and a flattering mouth worketh ruin." Yikes. Ouch. All right, so that is the end of Proverbs chapter 26. And now let us go ahead and sing Micah 6:8 again, and then we'll do a review song, or review scripture song. We'll do the one from the 16th. Or no, we did that one yesterday. We'll do the 17th, which is Proverbs 12:28. So we'll do that one. We'll do Micah once more, and then we'll do the review song, and then we'll do Micah again. So we'll get that one down today. So Micah, review song, and then Micah again, and then we'll wrap it up. Amen. So let me press play here, and we'll sing that a couple more times.
Micah 6:8. "He hath showed thee, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy God."
"He hath showed thee, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy God. He hath showed thee, O man, what is good, and what did the Lord require of thee? But to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy God. And to walk humbly with thy God. Amen. All right, so let's go back here to the 17th. And we'll do that one. Make sure we get back here. All right, 17th.
Proverbs 12:28. In the way of righteousness is life, and in the pathway thereof there is no death.
Amen. The way of righteousness is life, and in the pathway thereof there is no death. In the way of righteousness is life, and in the pathway thereof there's no death, no death, there's no death. In the way of righteousness is life, and in the pathway thereof there's no death. In the way of righteousness is life, and in the pathway thereof, there's no death, no death, there's no death. Amen. All right, so let's go back to the 26th, which is today. All right, the 26th, and we, I went too far. There we go.
Micah 6, all right. He hath showed thee, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy God.
Yeah. He hath shown thee, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy God. He hath showed thee, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy God, and to walk humbly with thy God. Amen. Hallelujah for that. Praise the Lord. All right, so that will end it for today's devotional and scripture song reading and Proverbs, scripture song singing and Proverbs reading. Amen. And so tomorrow's scripture song will be from Hebrews 2 verse 9, where it says, "But we see Jesus, who was made a little lower than the angels for the suffering of death, crowned with glory and honor, that he, by the grace of God, should taste death for every man." Amen. So that will be our scripture song for tomorrow. And again, tomorrow's topic for the Baptist Bread Devotional will be titled Faith to Reach Others. And so I hope you'll come back tomorrow for that. And I believe the author for that one is Tom Malone. So praise the Lord. And if you would like to get yourself a box of these Baptist Bread Devotionals, to keep one for yourself and then pass others pass the others to other people, like Christians, fellow Christians, or family members, or whoever you would like to give it to. The address to order those would be Baptist Bread at 37055 Joy Road, Westland, Michigan, 48185. And for those of you outside of the country, that's in the USA, the United States of America. And the phone number, if you'd like to reach them, is 734-425-0466. And their email is bb@joybaptist.com. And you can order yourself a box of those. I believe they come with 10 or 12 in them. And they're $12.95, and it's for 2 months. Right now we're in the middle of May, and then we have May and June. So the next box would include the months of July and August. So you'll probably get the ones for May and June if you order them right now. And so hope you'll want to do that. If you're interested in getting yourself a copy of this, they, like I said, they come in a box of 12, so you can keep one for yourself and pass them along to others. Or if you have a free table at your church or have a place at your church that you'd like to put them so people can grab them, amen. It's a good devotional book, amen. And it's Brother Tim Green puts these together. If you'd like to reach him, if they're a help and a blessing to you, well, you can tell him about it. And his address and email would be Evangelist Tim Green at P.O. Box 1, Day Heights, Ohio, 45150. And his website is www.timgreenministries.org. I have never been on there yet, but perhaps today I will check it out. And so you can contact him that way. Amen. All right, well, that'll about wrap it up. So before I go, I'd like to tell you that Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. He's not a way, and he's not a truth or a life. He is the way, the truth, and the life. And no man cometh to the Father but by him. So hope and pray you'll call on him today to save your soul, and he'll wash away all your sin, because he is the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. And nothing else can save you, friend. No amount of good works that you can tack on to salvation will do it, because Jesus Christ said on the cross, it is finished. Water baptism won't save your soul. Going to church won't save your soul. Doing a bunch of good works won't save your soul. All that stuff is good, and we should do that stuff, but it's not going to help you with salvation and getting to God, because you can't work your way to heaven. Can't work your way to God, because Jesus Christ said that it's through him, and even God the Father said that it's through Jesus Christ, his only begotten Son, and he is God manifest in the flesh, came down to this earth over 2,000 years ago, and he was born of a virgin, had a body prepared for him, and so he came into that body and lived a holy, sinless life, and then he went to that cross willingly the first time, didn't come here to set up a kingdom the first time, came down here to die for all men's sins. And so if you believe that, believe on his death, burial, and resurrection, and believe what he said, then he will save your soul. Amen. So get in that Bible and read it and study it and understand what the Lord's trying to tell you, that he wants you to be saved. Amen. And it's all about Jesus. So let's trust him today. And even after you're saved, keep trusting him. Watch and pray. Amen. And be sober-minded and make sure that we're always going after the Spirit and letting the Spirit control us and help us and guide us and direct us instead of getting in the flesh. Amen. So that's a good thing to do. Amen. So always take everything to the Lord in prayer and cast all our imaginations on him. Amen. So until next time, this is Brother Scott signing off. So may the Lord richly bless you, and see you all, Lord willing, later this afternoon as I come back with the Bible reading as we continue through the book of Nehemiah. Amen. So hope you'll come back for that later on this afternoon. All right, well, bye-bye for now. Thanks for watching.